Hello, everybody. Good evening. Good morning. Happy to be with you.
Good evening.
Yeah. Looks like there were not many questions. Otherwise, Sri Harsha was available to answer them. I'm going to talk about Open Madalika for about the first part. And after that, we will start with the practice with the DWSim. Okay. So let me start with this. So I'm going to give a brief introduction to Open Madalika. This is not supposed to be a session in which you will learn to use Open Madalika, but more to give an overview of Open Madalika. Okay. And I will explain to you as we go along why we are talking about Open Madalika in this DWSim workshop. That is something I would want to point out. I would compare this with DWSim in a little while. You will also understand. And there are some benefits in using Open Madalika, and there are also, of course, some learning curve, steeper learning curve in using Open Madalika. DWSim, on the other hand, is a lot easier to use. Okay. So I'll give an introduction to simulation itself, and then our contribution to Open Madalika, what it is, thermodynamics in Open Madalika, promotion of Open Madalika, and you know, so on. The first point I would like to make is that high tech helps common people. Why does it help? This is something very important. Let me just open this link. It's a link here. Okay. So you see this title came in the popular newspaper, Times of India. Cyclone Vardha, ISRO satellite saved 10,000 lives in India. 10,000 lives in Tamil Nadu, which is a state in India. So that is important because this story is important. Because sometimes people think that why should a country, developing countries, invest money in satellite technology, for example. And you saw the thing where, 10,000 lives in India were saved. And then India's high-tech activities are cost-effective. Chandrayaan 2 mission is cheaper than Hollywood film Interstellar. Right, this is a well-known fact. And then Mangalyaan mission, because we sent a satellite to Mars called Mangalyaan mission, and this is cheaper than the movie Gravity. Okay, this came in BBC News. And one of the reasons for cost-effective technologies is the use of technology. And one of the technology tools that we have deployed, we have used, is simulation. So this is something that we need to really use. As a matter of fact, when Reliance Industries, which put up world's largest single stream refining plant in Jamnagar, they did the entire thing through simulation. I don't think any pilot plant studies were conducted. Of course, pilot plant studies had been conducted earlier, and from that, all the parameters were determined. But there was no, it was the world's largest single stream refinery had been put up within time of 3 years, without cost overruns, without any experiments, all based on simulation. Okay. Now, Open Madalika is an equation-oriented environment. Equation-oriented environment means, let me just briefly explain the difference between equation-oriented and sequential modular. Okay, let me start with DWSim. DWSim is a sequential modular simulator. It does things in a sequence and it solves one module at a time. Okay. So for example, if you have several building blocks, several unit operations connected with each other, for example, yesterday you saw some streams going to a mixer and then mixer output going somewhere else and so on. Or maybe you will have a reactor, maybe you will have a mixer followed by a reactor, followed by a separator, a distillation column or something like that. What DWSim will do is it will solve each block separately. It will solve each block one at a time, one block at a time. Okay. Whereas in equation oriented modeling environment, equations from all the blocks are collected and they are solved simultaneously. All of them are solved simultaneously. That is what is meant by equation oriented modeling. It can handle algebraic equations, ordinary differential equations, differential algebraic equations. As a result, it can handle dynamics. And you can declare equations for every building block. On connecting blocks, equations get augmented automatically. What do you mean by declare? Declare means like the way we write in the class, we just say dx by dt equals something. We are declaring. Okay, you can do that in open model ego. Whereas you can't do it in let's say if you write a normal programming thing, it will not understand what is meant by x equals y. It doesn't know dx by dt equals f of x means that you have to evaluate this and assign it to f of x. Okay. It cannot accept, for example, symbolic variables. It cannot do any of that. You have to assign numerical values, right? On connecting blocks, equations get, so you have a set of equations for a block, another set of equations for another block, and you connect the blocks, these equations get augmented. And when you say solve, it will check whether the systems are solvable, and if the equations are solvable, and if solvable, it will solve, send this system to the solver, get the result and display the result. Of course, before it sends it to the solver, it will check whether the system is solvable. Gives several additional information. Open model ICA can be used for design also. For example, in DWSim, or for that matter in Simulink, or for that matter in Aspen Plus, or for that matter in Scilab XCOS, which are all sequential modular simulators. Each module will come with a set of methods. That is, it will say that these can be unknown, can be solved for. In order to do this, you need to provide these values. Finally, you're solving a set of equations in a block, and the equation should be solvable. Number of equations should be equal to number of unknowns and so on. And what are those equations that can be solved for? What are the variables that can be solved for is decided a priori. So you might have a system like adiabatic flash. It'll solve a set of problems, set of equations. Or you might have an isothermal flash. It'll solve another set of equations perhaps. Okay. So for each of those cases, the solution is hard-coded. It will solve and give you the result, right? But you cannot ask for something like, what should the input variable be in order to get the output? That may or may not be possible. Or you might say, let me specify some inputs, some outputs. Okay, calculate the missing inputs, missing outputs, and also the missing things in the box. It may not be able to do. So these are called design problems. Whereas open model ICA can solve for a variable inside a block, in the input, etc. Because for it, it's all equations. It'll just check whether the system of equations is solvable. If solvable, it will solve and give the result. Simulink cannot do it easily. Okay, Simulink cannot do it easily. Aspen Plus cannot do it easily. DWSim You have to do it by trial and error. Cannot do it easily means maybe in some cases you can do that, but a lot of trial and error, right? You might have to do adjust, for example, because you will learn about adjust. I think you will learn about adjust. So wherein you will specify the output, and by trial and error, it will calculate the input. Whereas in Open Modelica, it is just a solution of equations. And it uses Open Modelica uses Open Model, ODE, PAC, DASL, RADA5, etc. for solving. And solution for each building block can be plotted easily by the user. In fact, we'll see whether we can give a demo of this. Open Modelica is created by Professor Peter Fridzen of Linköping University in Sweden. We are working closely with him. We completed an Indo-Swedish strategic project on embedded systems using Open Modelica. We created Open Modelica spoken tutorials. In case anybody wants to learn Open Modelica, it's available here. So let me just show you. We have 14 tutorials in Open Modelica, starting from overview, examples, Open Modelica connectors, and then developing an equation-based model, flow and event handling, things like that, arrays in Modelica packages, and so on. In fact, in one of them, you will even do a bouncing ball, for example. Okay, this example is using Modelica library, using electrical library, using analog library. Here it is, if else, I think one of them has a bouncing ball, for example. So all equations are there. How does one write the equations? How does one simulate it? How does one plot? All of these are given. And you already know spoken tutorials. Using the same method, you can learn Open Modelica by yourself without any further help. Okay. So that is spoken tutorials. And I will explain to you about the chemical engineering support we provide to Open Modelica. Open Modelica is a great tool, but it doesn't have thermodynamic database. It didn't have at one time. Okay. So we thought that unless thermodynamics is available, it will not be of use to chemical engineers. Whereas DWSim has thermodynamic database, so can we make them available in Open Modelica? Okay. So we did some experiments. I'm going to quickly go through that and reach the final thing, because I have some slides to say that we tried this, we tried that, didn't work, so we tried this. But I don't want to spend too much time on that, but just to give a flavor of the work that we had done. So for example, DTL is what we will use, DWSim thermodynamic library, and ChemSep thermodynamics is there, and DWSim's own thermodynamics is there, and DTL functions are there, PT flash, enthalpy, PWEB, etc. Now, initially we thought we will call DWSim, let DWSim sit outside. From Open Modelica, we will call DWSim. So we did that. And then we did two approaches, Python C API, and then client server approach. This is Python C API. This is the client server approach. And of course, one of them was better. In fact, client server was better. But both problems were very slow. So what we did was we developed a native thermodynamic engine in Open Modelica. And ChemSep database has open source database, more than 400 compounds, enriched with a good binary interaction parameter data set, used by DWSim as well, and written in XML format. What we did was we ported this XML into Open Modelica classes. We rewrote the entire thermodynamic database into Open Modelica. And that was the database. Then the functions also got ported for every compound. We created this, okay? And then binary interaction parameters, and then phase equilibria models, and then native port is faster than imported. Imported means imported from DWSim. Okay. And then, in fact, we even wrote a paper, implementation of property database and thermodynamic calculations in Open Modelica for chemical process simulation. Rahul Jain was my MTech student. You can see Priyam Nayak's name. You see Professor Naren, Daniel Wagner, and Peter Fritzen, who created Open Modelica. After that, once we had thermodynamics, we could add building blocks, unit operations. And then that we got another paper, chemical process simulation using Open Modelica. You can see this. In fact, let me show you. You have the papers here. It's a property database. And we have compared lots of, for example, Aspen data, DWSim data, Open Modelica data. Okay, this is for methanol mole fraction, and this is using NRTL. And then Peng-Robinson method, this is ethane-propane system using Aspen, DWSim, Open Modelica. Okay, once again, this is UNIFAC model, acetic acid, MEK binary component system. Once again, we have compared all these three. This is Aspen, DWSim, Open Modelica comparison once again. This is ethanol water thing, and you can just see azeotrope also being formed. Once again, all of them match. Okay, so this was the first paper. Let me close this. And this is the chemical process simulation using Open Modelica. And here we have done various, how it is structured and so on. Here I wanted to show you steam distillation apparatus that we simulated. And I'll show you the equations also. So here are the equations. Okay, you can see dynamic equations are there. Differential equations are there. And it can compare the Open Modelica work that is in solid line with the original paper from which we have taken points and we have compared. And so how does one write derivative? Derivative equals dt equals this. Notice here are the equations. This is what I'm saying, declare equations. Declare equations. Where is it solved? It is not solved here. It is solved in a solver, like Dasir, for example. It's solved in ODE pack, for example, right? So this is how equations are formulated. You have to state the parameters. These are all constants. Then you can say that these are my variables. When you state the variables, you can specify the units, for example. Then it will check for consistency of units in an equation. And then starting value, you can initial guess you can give, for example, for different variables you can give. And then these are the equations. So these are the equations. These are algebraic equations. This is a differential equation. And then if then else command is also there. So it has a programming language. You have to learn that programming language to do this. Okay. And similarly, here is one. Property correlations for the semi-batch reactor as given in Shacham et al. So we have taken example from there, and then we this is how properties are estimated. Okay. We minimize this. Okay, here we are. It's the same system, and then we compared. And here, of course, it's a design problem, and using adjust, for example, we. This is Y2 was not given, Y3 was not given. It's a flash, right? Steady state flash, and temperature was not given. Inlet temperature was not given. So you have to find this. So it's a design problem. And then this is using Open Modelica. This is using DWSim. And this is using trial and error, using adjust, whereas this was done automatically. Okay. Now let me spend a little bit of time on the way we promote Open Modelica. Okay. So that let me come here. By the way, we conduct large amount of training. So you can see statistics, training. I can even show you because all the information is public information. So if I say KLMNO on Modelica filter, you can see that we have trained more than 12,000 people on Open Modelica. And who has had this Open Modelica training? You can see various colleges that are doing this. Okay. In fact, you can even view the participants. For example, 16th February 2021 in Nehru Institute of Technology, Coimbatore, 40 people underwent Open Modelica Aeronautical Engineering. View participants. It's here. You can see the 40 people, right? So we actually have all the information already available. So we have trained a total of 12,196 people through 224 workshops using Open Modelica spoken tutorials. Okay, that's the power of spoken tutorials. Okay, and then this is training. Then we do content creation also. We have a textbook companion. We have Open Modelica flow sheeting. Okay, I'll come to that. Library of unit operations. So I showed you the second paper. For that, we have replicated DWSim's unit operation models in Open Modelica. We are also creating a GUI for chemical process simulation using Open Modelica. Okay. In fact, I'm not sure whether Priyam will give a demo. Maybe he'll give a demo of this. And then initial conditions are difficult to get in Open Modelica because some of the flow sheets that we have solved have lots of equations. So let me give some examples of that. Okay. You go to om.fossey.in. So we have a spoken tutorial. You can go from here also. We have a textbook companion project. So let me just show that. So what is it? Completed books. So this is set of equations. You can see these are all problems that are getting solved by students from different parts of India. I don't think we have had any input for this from overseas. So we have 68 textbooks present here. Textbook companion. Yesterday I talked to you about DWSim textbook companion. Here it is, Open Modelica textbook companion. Open Modelica textbook company. Okay. And then orders one, what is the procedure, submission guidelines, book proposal. Once again, the same method that Priyam talked about yesterday of when is a paper, when is a proposal accepted is followed here also. And then you can see books in progress. Well, not many books. There are 8 books in progress. Okay. Internship forms and so on. And then let me go to flow sheeting project. Okay, flow sheeting project, you have completed flow sheets. Okay, you can see there are 51 flow sheets that have been simulated using Open Modelica. Okay, in fact, you can see here, let me see if I can find, Kaushik Datta is the person who created the spoken tutorials on DWSim. He has created, and you see this Sriharsha is available here. He's helping with this project. He has joined our project as a full-time staff member. So if I click this, you can see that it is Sriharsha, and he's from Sri Venkateswara University College of Engineering, Tirupati, using Open Modelica version 14.01.14. And then he has taken it from this paper. Okay. And then effect of column sequence on the separation compounds. You can download the abstract. You can download the flow sheet. All of that is available without login. See this login? It says login because I have not logged in. Okay. What are the different things? So, I'm almost at the end of my presentation. After that, I'm going to ask Priyam to give the demo. Initial conditions in Open Modelica are sometimes difficult. The flow sheets that I showed you, 51 flow sheets that I showed you, have all of them solve all the equations simultaneously. And in fact, there are some systems where the number of equations can be of the order of like 10,000, 20,000, and so on, right? Initial conditions are difficult to get in the Open Modelica. So can we do a sequential modular simulation to arrive at initial conditions? For example, I have a PhD student who is working on batch process simulation, and he has developed a multi-component distillation. So product one, slop one, product two, slop two, and so on. It can do it for any number of components using the thermodynamics, of course. And then he has used Petri nets that it comes built in Open Modelica. So I'm going to give the stage to Priyam, who will give a demonstration of Open Modelica. Priyam, are you there?
Hello.
Yeah. Priyam,
hello.
Priyam, before I hand over, let's see whether there is any question.
Sure, sir.
There are any questions, we can answer them. If there are any questions, I'll be able to answer them. We'll explore, we'll try. And Priyam can give a demo. Priyam, over to you. You can get started. If there are questions, I'll answer them in the meantime.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
So what you see currently is called OMEdit, Open Modelica Connection Editor. By the way, when you download and install Open Modelica, the whole software, there are multiple components that comes along with this software. Okay. One is this Open Modelica Connection Editor or OMEdit. Then you have OM Shell, OM Python. Okay. But what I'm going to talk about specifically today, what I'm going to demonstrate now is Open Modelica Connection Editor, because it is mainly used for this modeling and simulation purpose. Okay. So the window you see right here is called Open Modelica Connection Editor. Now on your left side, in the left side of the screen, what you see is called Libraries Browser. All right. In this Libraries Browser, you can see you have some libraries loaded here. And as Professor Kannan said that, as Professor Kannan mentioned about our contribution to Open Modelica, that we have contributed or we have developed the chemical library. Okay. So what you see here in the library browser, there's this library called Modelica, which is a by default library that comes preloaded with Open Modelica and OMEdit. Okay. So if you just expand this Modelica library, you can see that there are different libraries. Like there is a library for electrical, there's a library for mechanical, there's library for thermal. All right, there are libraries for fluid and for mathematical operations, but there is no library for chemical simulation. Okay, so what we have developed is a library for chemical process simulation, which was not available in the Modelica library. Now, let me load that library and let me open the library that I have. By the way, the library what I'm talking about is available. So let me open the Modelica library. I'll point out from where you can download the library, because it's open source and it is available for everyone to download and use. So that I'll point out later, but let me first give a demo of the library. Okay. So I have loaded a Modelica file, which is getting loaded, and okay. So now you see here file is appearing, a library is appearing called a simulator, and this is the chemical process simulation library that Professor Kannan mentioned that we have developed at IIT Bombay. Okay, so we have developed, like he mentioned, we have developed the thermodynamics, we have developed unit operations and everything for this particular library. Okay, so if I just expand this library, there are multiple packages inside this library. One is called user guide. And then you have called files, then you have streams, unit operations, examples, and all of that. Okay, so let me just quickly go through the important ones. Okay, I'll not go through everything. Let me just go through the important one that will be interest to all of you. So you have this library first of all called KIMSEP database. Now initially when we started with the when we thought about performing chemical process simulation in OpenModelica, the first requirement that is necessary in any simulator is to have a component database, otherwise we can't simulate anything, right? So the first step was to create a component database. Now we cannot just like that create a component database on our own. So what we did was that we saw that KIMSEP Lite has that KIMSEP has this database which we tried to import in OpenModelica using Python, and this work was done by Rahul Jain. So he imported all the chemicals that were available in KIMSEP database into OpenModelica by writing a Python code. Okay, so now as I expanded the library, you can see that all these components are available here. I mean, whatever you have noticed yesterday in the KIMSEP database in DWSim, all those components are also available as a part of KIMSEP library in OpenModelica as well. Okay, and the properties are also available. Okay, so it's not just the component, but the properties as well. All the properties are also available there here. Okay. So this is with the KIMSEP database. Now, once we have developed the compound database, the next thing is to have a thermodynamics. Okay. So initially we tried to just call the thermodynamics of DWSim and then use that to perform simulation in OpenModelica. But that was a bit time taking process. So we thought that why not develop the thermodynamics itself in the OpenModelica. And therefore we started developing thermodynamic functions, thermodynamic packages in OpenModelica. If you see, these are the various thermodynamic functions that are available in OpenModelica, which are necessary for performing chemical process simulation. And then, show this properly, yeah. And then these are the thermodynamic packages that are available in OpenModelica. So right now, I mean, when you have done DWSim yesterday, you would have noticed that there are lots of thermodynamic packages that are there in DWSim, but all of them have not been yet imported in OpenModelica. So currently OpenModelica chemical library support this NRTL, Raoult's Law, UNIFAC, UNIQUAC, Peng Robinson and Grayson Street thermodynamic packages. We are also in the process of developing a few more thermodynamic packages in OpenModelica. Okay, so now that we have the chemical database, now we have the compound database, now that we have the thermodynamic packages, the next important thing to have is to have the unit operations and the material streams, right? So what we did was we then modeled the unit operation and the material stream also in OpenModelica. So if you see, if I expand these two packages, streams and unit operations, you can see that we have the material streams here. Okay. And then you have the unit operations here. Now, if I click on this material stream, actually, what you see in the center is the code for the material stream. Okay. So initially the variables are declared and then model equations are coded. So if you see, there is this mole balance, there is component balance, then there is some bubble point calculation and all of that. Okay, so whatever model equations that are required that are necessary in a material stream are available here, and therefore the material stream has been developed in OpenModelica. And what you see on the right is something called as documentation browser. So this is a short documentation about the material stream model that is developed in OpenModelica. Okay, so I don't know if it is right now, it might be too small for you to read, but yeah, I mean, if you download and open it, you can probably go through it and see. I mean, you can find the information that what is this material stream all about. Okay, and it is also written at the bottom at the end that, you know, for demonstration on how to use this model to simulate a material stream, go to this example. So I'll come to that demonstration later. Okay, so this is with material stream, and then you have the unit operations. So typically all the unit operations that are available as a part of DWSim's native library, built-in library, are also made available in OpenModelica. So mixer, heater, and then you have the heat exchangers, then you have the pumps. Okay, you have a distillation column, you have the reactors. So all of that are also available in OpenModelica. Okay, so once again, if you go to any of this model, let's say if I go to the model for a heater, here you can find out, initially the variables are declared and then the model equations are declared. The model equations are coded for OpenModelica, for heater in OpenModelica. And again, on your right, you can find out you can find some information about this model as to what are the different variables that have been declared and what are the input variables and what are the output variables. All of that has been mentioned here in the documentation for this model. Okay, so this is to do with unit operations. Now, since you have Now everything in place. You have a chemical compound database in place. You have a thermodynamic packages in place. You have streams and unit operations in place. Now, how do we simulate a particular, particular unit operation? How do we simulate a heater? How do you simulate a column and all of that? Now, the things are not as easy and straightforward as you do in DWSim, because DWSim has got a nice UI on top of it, so you can just drag and drop things and enter values and simulate. But that is not yet available in OpenModelica. I mean, that was not available in OpenModelica. So initially, we started the simulation. Once we developed the model, and then to simulate a particular heater, mixer, or any flow sheet, we had to write some few. We had to write a few lines of code. But then we are also working on creating a UI on top of this, so that you need not always write code for performing simulation. You can just drag and drop things and enter values and simulate, like how you do in DWSim. So that is an ongoing work, which is almost complete. Okay, but what I'm going to give you a demonstration is that how the coding thing works in OpenModelica. So if I expand this examples library, you can see that it has an example of all the unit operations, how you simulate every unit operation in OpenModelica. So how you simulate a material stream, how you simulate a heater, how you simulate a cooler, how you simulate a distillation column, all of that, distillation, all of that is available. Okay, so let me just pick a very take a very small example of heater. So if I expand this heater stream, there is this file called heater simulation, on which I can double click. And let me first show you the diagram view. So this is what is the diagram view of the heater. Okay. There is a material stream going in, and then there's a material stream coming out, and then there's an energy stream. The one in red is the energy stream. Okay. So now this is my heater. This is a simulation of a heater, and when I drag and drop things here also, some amount of drag and drops works here as well, but not completely. Like after you drag and drop certain things and connect, you will have to pass the variables by writing writing few lines of code. For example, if I just point here, these five lines of code, the equation part has to be written. Okay, so what is the pressure that I want to pass, what is the temperature that I want to give for the material stream, and then what is the flow rate, all this has to be written by some lines of code, and we follow OpenModelica, we follow the Modelica convention for that. Okay, if you want to learn that, you can obviously, you can definitely refer our spoken tutorials in OpenModelica for that, as to how to write a code in OpenModelica. And some lines of code are automatically generated. For example, these connect equations and all, they get automatically generated when we drag and drop things and when we connect them. Okay. Now, if I want to simulate this model, first of all, in OpenModelica, the basic requirement to simulate any model is to check the degrees of freedom. Okay, so basically you have to see if your number of equations is equal to the number of unknowns. Okay, if that condition is satisfied, then only the model is solvable. So first, before I go for solving this model, I'll first check the correctness of this model. Okay, and once I do that, here I have a pop-up window which says that heater simulation has 347 equations and 347 variables. Okay, so that means my degree of freedom is closed, and therefore this model can now be solved. Okay, so before I want to solve a model, I can do the simulation setup for the model. So what happens in a simulation setup? Basically, we can define for how much time we are going to simulate the model. Now, in this case, it is a steady state model, so it doesn't matter for how much time we want to simulate, but this is necessary when we want to simulate a dynamic simulation, when we want to simulate a dynamic model, okay, where variable changes with respect to time. And also, depending on the complexity of the model, depending on the type of equations that we are using, we can choose the method of integration, okay, that is necessary. Like Kanansa mentioned earlier, there are different methods of integration available, Euler and RK, trapezoid, Dassel, all of that. So by default method is Dassel, and this is what I'm going to keep. Okay, and let me just click on okay, and I am going to simulate this model now. So as I click on this model, you can see a window appears, and it starts, the model first starts getting compiled. So the model is getting compiled, and probably in a few seconds we'll see the results now. Okay, so if you see, as soon as the simulation gets completed, the browser automatically changes. So initially, if you remember, we were in this modeling browser where you are seeing the code. Now, if the simulation is successful, the window is automatically switched to the plotting window, where you can see the variable for the result and where you can plot the graphs for that. Okay, if you want to see any graph, you can plot them. So let's say if you want to see the stream S2 and some of its properties. some of its properties, then you can probably see the S2 window. You can click on that S2 and then you can see the flow rates and all of that. Okay. So this was my inlet flow rate, and this was the component wise flow rate, all of that. Okay, so likewise, we have examples available for all the unit operations that we have made available in OpenModelica. You have example for heater, you have example for distillation column. So here is an example for distillation column. If you see, let me open the distillation column. Yeah, so this is a distillation column example that you have. And if you want to see how many equations are getting solved here, probably it will be more than what was there in heater. This is 792 equations and 792 variables. Okay. So once again, since the degree of freedom is closed, this system is solvable. And if you just click on, if we simply want to click on simulate flow sheet, we can just click on this arrow button to simulate. Else, if you want to change the method of integration or if you want to change anything in the setup timing and all, you can do that by going to simulation setup. Okay. Now let me quickly demonstrate you the dynamic simulation that Professor Kannan mentioned earlier, that the semi-batch distillation, which we have mentioned in the INDC paper that we wrote. So let me open that example. Okay, so this is the semi-batch model that sir mentioned earlier, which we wrote. So here the thermodynamic functions are available for this particular model, and then here we have the model equations. Okay, so let's say I want to run this this particular problem statement was taken from a paper which was published in Chemical Engineering Education by Shasham. So if you want to simulate this model, let's go to this simulation setup and let us run this model for, let's say, 30 minutes. Okay, so if I want to run this model for 30 minutes, I am giving the timing in seconds, and I just click on OK. So once I click on OK, my model starts getting compiled. And here I have my model compiled, and therefore you can see the results are displayed in this plotting perspective, plotting browser. Okay. And if you want to, see a particular, let me just change the unit. Yeah. So if I want to plot the temperature, if I want to see how the temperature is varying so with respect to time, here I can see how the temperature is getting varied with respect to time for the semi-batch distillation model. And if you want to see how the compositions are varying, let's say if I want to see how x1 x2 and then y1 y2, yeah, so how the compositions are varying, so this is how the compositions are varying for the model. Same results has been published, and you can find that in that paper as well, which we have published, and it's there. This is what you see here. This is the results that is available in the Chemical Engineering Education paper from which we have taken the problem statement. Okay, so I'm done with my simulation demonstration. So let me just quickly just give you the link of the this is the link. We have hosted all our libraries. We have hosted our chemical library that we have developed in this GitHub by the name OM Chemsim under FOSSI's repository. So the library and some of the sample flow sheets, all of that is available here. I'll put the link in the chat window. So those who are interested in exploring this further and want to contribute to the OpenModelica flow sheeting project can visit this library and download the code and get started with. There is enough documentation present right now for you to get started with the simulation. But first, what I recommend is that you must learn OpenModelica if you want to work in this library and if you want to perform any simulation using this library. It is necessary that you learn OpenModelica first, and then you can download this library and you can start simulating. We are in the process of creating spoken tutorials on how to use this library to perform chemical process simulation. So we are working on that as well. Probably it will take some time to get it done, but as I said, there is enough documentation available inside this library to help you out as to how to use this library. Okay, so I'll put this link in the chat window. If anyone is interested, they can probably.
Priyam sir.
Yeah.
Sir, this is Kunjan Patel. I have a question.
Yeah, Kunjan. Yeah.
Sir, in this OpenModelica software which you just explained, I just want to know that when we have to write the code and when it will automatically get displayed on the browser. I didn't get. Can you just clarify about that?
Automatically getting displayed. Okay, so the
because this
basically please go ahead.
Because this mainly works on this programming language, right? Which you explained, Python.
So this works using the language called Modlica. So the language behind Open Modlica is called Modlica. Modlica is a language how there is C, C++, Python. There's this language called Modlica. And Open Modlica is the open source implementation of Modlica language. Like I know if you have heard about Dimola. So Dimola is also based on Modlica language, but it's a commercial implementation of Modlica language. Okay. And Open Modlica is an open source implementation of Modlica language.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now coming to the question that you asked. So initially, let's say that if you already have the models available with you, which you want to simulate, then you need not do much writing of code and all. You can just use those existing models, connect them, and then simulate them. But yes, if the models that you want to simulate is already not available, then probably you have to first create your own model. So that's where you need to have the knowledge of Open Modlica. And then once you have created the model, you can use that to simulate your own flow sheet or whatever you want to simulate and get the results.
Okay, so to conclude, like if you want to create a model, then accordingly, we need to take step-by-step process for writing the code.
Yes. So let's say, you want to have a special, an isomerization unit. Okay, that is something not available right now in OpenModlica. So what you can do is you can first of all write the model for isomerization unit, and probably you can use the existing components and the thermodynamic data.
Voice is not coming. Can you just repeat again what you said?
What Priyam was telling. In case you already have the model, whatever model you want, if it is already in the library, go and use it. If the model is not there in the library, then if you want, you can write a new model, right? It is true of any simulator. For example, if there is no unit operation present in DWSim for what you want to simulate, you have to write the equation in the form of a custom model. Here also you can. Okay, here you do it using equations. That's all there is to it. There you have to use Python. Python in DWSim. Here you can solve it using, you can write the equations using the Modlica equations. You have to learn the Modlica language and do that. But it is, this is using Open Modlica is an order of magnitude more difficult than DWSim. DWSim is very easy. You just click, drag, drop, connect, simulate. It's sequential modular simulation, a lot easier to do. What we are doing here is equation-oriented approach. The benefit is that you can attempt design equations, number one. Number two, you can also do dynamic equations. Dynamic simulation you can do.
Yes.
I would say it is 10 times more powerful.
Sorry, sir. Come again.
It is also 10 times more powerful.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. If you want the power, then you have to spend time in learning and learning to use it.
Right, sir. Okay, thank you.
Okay. Are there any other questions?
Sir, I have a question.
Yeah.
I found that there are three different download files of Open Modlica: official release, stable development, and nightly build. So which of them is a more appropriate for chemical simulation?
Just as in DWSim, there are updates. In fact, they have nightly builds. Nightly builds, and they have a stable release and so on. Basically, when we give the instructions for our simulator, we will tell what version you should use. Okay, you should go by that. If you want to use our thing. Otherwise, if you just want to use Open Modlica, you want to learn that, use the you can use the nightly build if you want. Priyam, what is your recommendation?
So I would recommend to use the at least a stable version, because nightly builds does have some bugs, and bug fixings keeps happening every fortnight. So it's better that they use a stable version, because else they will keep on updating every time there's a bug fix and all of that. So let's say currently there's a nightly build coming up for OpenModelica 1.17. So you take the latest stable version, which is OpenModelica 1.16, and work on that. Okay. And once you have a stable version of 1.17, then you can update your OpenModelica version.
Okay, sir. Thanks.
Sir, I have a doubt. If you want to model any, if there is a new equipment, a modified one with a newer design, so how do we model that in OpenModelica? I mean, the design parameters and all, is there any way to feed all those?
See, it is just that it makes modeling easier. How will you do this in C programming? Supposing you have to do this in C programming, you have to collect all the information, right? Similarly, you have to collect all the information. It's just that instead of C, you do it in Modelica language. That's all.
Sir, and a crude question, new to this. Sir, why model in the first place?
Why model in the first place? I explained to you the role of simulation, right? At the beginning.
Yes, sir. Okay. That's fine, sir.
Yes.
Yeah.